Hi everybody, in this video let's talk about another type of meniscal tear, the complex meniscal tear, okay? So the complex meniscal tear is a combination of different patterns of meniscal tears at the same meniscal region. So for example, here in this picture, we can see three different patterns of meniscal tears at the same meniscal region. Horizontal type, vertical longitudinal type, and a partial radial type, a partial radial tear. So in case of complex tears, it's possible to identify the combination of the different patterns of meniscal tears, the primary patterns of meniscal tears. And that definition, it's very useful to make a distinction between the complex tear and the meniscal maceration, right? In case of meniscal maceration, the meniscus loses its normal morphology and signal, and it's not possible to identify the primary patterns of or the different patterns of meniscal tear in a specific meniscal region. Okay, and how we can see the complex tear on the MRI of the knee? And the answer is, it depends. It depends where is the location of the complex tear and what are the components of the specific complex tear that you are evaluating, right? For example, in this case here, we can see a complex tear at the posterior horn of the meniscus. So here is the horizontal component, here is the radial component, it's a radial, partial radial tear, and here is the vertical longitudinal component of this complex tear. In the short axis, in the meniscal short axis, that in this case is the sagittal plane, in this first slice right here, we can see the horizontal tear. In the second slice, that's passing through the radial tear, we can see the partial radial tear, the horizontal tear, and the vertical longitudinal tear. And in the last slice, more laterally, we can identify two different components of this complex tear, the horizontal component and the vertical longitudinal component, okay? And in the meniscal long axis, that in this case is the coronal plane, we can also see the different patterns of meniscal tears. This horizontal line, it counts for the horizontal tear. This other image right here is the partial cleft sign of the partial radial tear. And this other image here at the periphery of the meniscus, it counts for the longitudinal vertical component of this complex tear, okay? So it will depend on what's the type of meniscal tear, where it's located, what are the components of the complex tear that you are evaluating. So now let's go to some examples of complex tears. So in this first case, this is a case of a complex tear of the posterior horn of the medial meniscus with two meniscal components, a radial partial tear and a vertical longitudinal tear. Look here, the partial radial tear. We can see the a partial gold sign right here in the short axis of the meniscus. And we can also identify the horizontal vertical tear right here in this region. Okay, so this is the sagittal plane. On the coronal plane, we can appreciate that the vertical longitudinal tear, it goes further anteriorly. Look here, that's the horizontal, the vertical longitudinal tear going to the meniscal body. And here in the area of the posterior horn of the medial meniscus, we can see a partial cleft sign here. That is caused by a partial radial tear, and also here it's part of this partial cleft sign. Look at the meniscus, it's blurred in this region, probably is the region of transition between the radial tear and the rest of the periphery of the meniscus. On the axial plane, this axial plane is amazing to see this complex tear in this case. Look here, the longitudinal vertical tear, and here the radial partial tear. So that's our first case, a complex tear of the posterior horn of the medial meniscus, radial component and vertical longitudinal component. Let's go to the second case. This case is also a case of a complex tear of the posterior horn or a junction between the posterior horn and the meniscal body. So in the coronal plane, we can see this longitudinal vertical tear right here. But when we look this area here at the transition between the posterior horn and the meniscal body, we can also see another component, maybe another component, a horizontal tear right here in this region. And on the sagittal plane, we can see the horizontal tear right here, the horizontal component right here. So that's another case of a complex tear. And this time we could identify two components, horizontal tear and longitudinal vertical tear. Okay. So in the third example, I'd like to show you an example of meniscal maceration, right? Sometimes it's hard to make to differentiate between a complex tear and a meniscal maceration, but I think that the basic point is this: in the meniscal maceration, it's difficult to identify the meniscal margins, it's difficult to identify the meniscal morphology, and it's also difficult to identify the patterns of meniscal tear. So this is an example of a meniscal maceration, and this is a very common place of meniscal maceration, the anterior horn of the lateral meniscus. I've seen a lot of cases of meniscal maceration in this region. Another region that's common to see meniscal maceration is the posterior horn of the medial meniscus, because most of the time it's a degenerative change. By the way, talking about a common place of meniscal maceration, in this case, the horizontal, I'm going to show you a paper that some researchers, they found some interesting facts about meniscal maceration of the anterior horn of the lateral meniscus. But continuing on our case here, the coronal plane, we can see the meniscal maceration right here. It extends until the transition with the meniscal body. And the axial plane, we can also see this region of the meniscal maceration right here. Here's a parameniscal cyst. There's also a parameniscal fat edema around this area of meniscal maceration. And that is the paper that I've told you. Some researchers, they found a specific type of meniscal tears. They call that this tear a macerated tear that occurs in the anterior horn of the lateral meniscus. They studied 60 patients, and 42% of these patients, they had this type of macerated tear. Okay, this is a free article. If you want to know more about this, just go on PubMed and look for it. Okay, so that's it for this video. Have a great day. Thank you for your attention, and until next video.